Hey guys, Ken Jung here. We just want to say thank you for taking the time to like our Facebook page. We know your time is valuable and it probably took, you know, maybe half a second or less to click on our page and like it. That's commitment. If we could, we'd click you back. We'd click you so hard you'd still feel it in the morning.
Even if you've never seen The Hangover or The Hangover Part 2, there's a chance you've heard the story of Ken Jeong. He's one of the most famous physicians in the world. But these days, he's jumped from the doctor's office to the red carpet. Ken Jeong traded in his MD license for a SAG card and a starring role as international criminal Leslie Chow in the Hangover series.
So long, gay boys!
Yeah, I know, it sounds unbelievable. I get it, you know, but that's my story.
And if you think his story is unbelievable, you're not the only one.
Ken, the actor, there's no real person. That's a made-up identity to fool people. People don't believe it, but Leslie Chow is a real person.
Backing up his story is co-star Bradley Cooper.
Mr. Chow is the real guy, and he's kind of a tyrant.
Ah! Ellie, grab the gun!
I don't think anyone in their right mind would ever believe that. You know, I'm Ken Jeong. I'm not Mr. Chow. It's just a character.
However, we heard a different story.
I'm taking my wire off.
When Chow didn't think our cameras were still rolling.
Ken Jeong is like some sort of beard. That's more fake than fake.
So if there is no Ken Jeong, then who is Leslie Chow?
Leslie Chow originally is from Taiwan.
The legend is he was raised by a dad who made him fight the family dog. So when you think about that, you think about where he came from. In the streets of Shanghai, somebody told me, but he was raised fighting dogs.
According to Galifianakis, there is a lot more to this unbelievable story, even by Hollywood standards.
He got his master's in reflexology. He moved to the States, and he burnt three national parks.
I'm not active by trade. I'm more of a international criminal. It involved telemarketing, you know, it was kind of email fraud, the Saturday morning cartoon.
For Chow, transitioning to Hollywood player seemed like a natural progression.
I needed to hide some blood money and to do it in the guise of like some Hollywood movie.
He basically had a bag of money and said he wanted to get in the movie business. So I thought, okay, we could write a part around this kind of shady Asian gangster and let's just have him play a shady Asian gangster. And he killed in the part.
Once he got the part, Chow created an elaborate alter ego and backstory to protect his financial involvement in the film.
I had to hire a vocal coach, dialogue coach, and he taught me how to concentrate and any stupid impulse you have in your body, and you compress it, and then you get Ken Jeong.
Hi, I'm Ken. I'm really nervous about everything. Wow.
Ah, so stupid. That is fake voice. Stupid accent.
As opposed to normal actors where they make a suggestion and Todd can decide yes or no, and I like that, it's really hard to turn Chow down. There's a real danger factor there.
Chow and I, we try to keep our arguments and our discussions or our disagreements off the set. But in a weird way, I always think there's a mistake because when you're on the set, at least there are witnesses.
Galifianakis says he's been in fear for his life during the production on all three Hangover films.
The other day, I was driven home and there was a small fire in my back seat of my car. And as I'm putting out the fire in my back seat of the car, I get a text from Leslie Chow, Ken Jeong, saying, how's your back seat?
Yeah, I set fire to Fat Boy Ka because he's fat.
I don't think he was trying to kill Zach, but he finds humor in unpleasant things.
I was taking a nap on the set, and I wake up. And there's an arrow from a bow and arrow in my mouth, and Ken was playing with my tonsils in the back with the arrow. And I take the arrow, and I'm like, what are you doing? He goes, Happy Easter.
I often go into my trailer, and he's there naked, and he keeps saying that the shower's broken in his, which, I mean, he wasn't in the shower, so I'm not quite sure what that's about.
When we reached out to co-star Ed Helms, he declined to speak on camera, but did release this statement. I have the greatest respect and admiration for Ken Jeong. He's been a great friend, and I've enjoyed every minute working with him. As for the other ridiculous rumors, I have no comment at this time. Chow's behavior on the set was very unprofessional, according to guest star John Goodman.
No, he shouldn't be in the film business because he's dangerous. He killed a grip through treachery.
There's a fine line between killing a grip and a grip who accidentally slipped on a banana peel and got shanked and impaled by a butter knife. Fine line.
Now, what am I going to do? Shut the movie down, or do we just sort of soldier on? People have been through worse things.
Since filming this interview, authorities have reported that Chow has gone underground. However, with the upcoming release of The Hangover Part 3 in late May, the filmmakers believe they haven't seen the last of Leslie Chow.
I wouldn't honestly work with him again because it's sort of you sell your soul to the devil kind of thing, and there's easier ways to make a living.